Hey guys, this is Yousef with thatsitguys.com. I previously made a tutorial on how to connect an Xbox One controller to a PC, which astonishingly received a crazy amount of views. After this video was released, one of the common questions we received was, can the controller be connected wirelessly? And we had to respond with no, because there was no way to do that at the time. However, Microsoft has finally released the Xbox One wireless adapter for Windows, which I recently reviewed in another video here. This adapter was only available for Windows 10, but now Microsoft has made it compatible with Windows 7 and 8 as well. If you are thinking about buying the Xbox One wireless adapter for Windows, or you already have one, then let me go ahead and show you how to get everything hooked up to your PC. In the description of this video is a link to Microsoft's Xbox One wireless adapter for Windows, which you obviously need for this tutorial. This adapter is compatible with Windows 7, as well as newer operating systems such as Windows 8 and 10. Installing the wireless adapter on Windows 7, 8, or 10 is actually easy. All you should have to do is plug the wireless adapter into your PC, then Windows automatically downloads the drivers for you. This video is here to help anyone who is having difficulty getting that to work. The first step is to confirm you are running the latest Windows updates. Microsoft has automatic updates on by default, but if you didn't allow that or you haven't restarted your machine recently, the wireless adapter may not work and install properly. So to apply the newest Windows update to your PC, press the Windows key on your computer and then type Windows Update. Run Windows Update, making sure you select all the recommended updates, and restart the machine as requested until your system is up to date. This may require running Windows Update a few times as certain updates are incremental or have prerequisites. Once your PC is completely updated, it should search for and automatically download the drivers when you plug the wireless adapter in. If it does, then you're all set and you're ready to use your controller. If you're still having problems, then the next step is to manually run the automatic driver search process. Click on the start menu and type Device Manager. Under Other Devices, you should see Xbox ACC. Right-click on it and select Update Driver Software. Then click on Search Automatically for Updated Driver Software. Then Windows starts searching online for the driver and should successfully install the drivers. If it's still not working, I'll show you how to download it manually in order to get the drivers to work for your adapter. In the description of this video, we have also provided a link to the driver of the adapter. Open the link and open the Microsoft Update Catalog link in Internet Explorer specifically. This can be done by copying the link into Internet Explorer. It may ask you to download something when you open the page, go ahead and download it. Ignoring the DFU links, the first driver is for 64-bit machines, and the second is for 32-bit machines. Since I'm running a 64-bit computer, I am selecting the first link by adding it to my basket. Click on View Basket, then Download. Choose a temporary folder, such as your Downloads folder, then click Continue. Close the window and open up the downloaded driver in the folder you chose, which was Downloads for me. Open the file until you see four files. Select all the files, right-click, and extract them to the same folder, which is Downloads for me. Go to the folder, right-click on XB1 USB, and click Install. At this point, your driver should be installed and your controller should work properly. I was also able to test out the headset which came with my Xbox One that plugs into the controller. This was an easy setup since Windows automatically recognized the headset. To use the headset, first make sure your controller is recognized by Windows 10, then right-click on the speaker icon and select Recording Devices. Right-click on Headset Microphone and set it as a default. Then click on the playback tab and do the same. Then click on OK. And now you should be able to use your headset for in-game chat or even Skype or Google Hangouts. If you run into any issues with your installation, leave a comment below and head over to our forums, which are linked in the video description below, and we'll be glad to help. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to subscribe for more videos, including more tutorials, reviews, and other tech news.